In this section, we'll look at the consonant system of English. What defines consonants as a group of sounds is the degree of obstruction created by the articulators. Consonants require a fair amount of obstruction, and when we describe a consonant sound, what we're mostly doing is describing how that obstruction works. As we talk about consonants in this course, we'll have a specific focus on the sounds that are phonemes in English. In other words, the sounds that are used in English to indicate differences in meaning. Most consonant sounds and symbols are pretty familiar to people. The phonetic transcription symbols we use are pretty similar to the way we spell these sounds in standard orthography. In a few cases, you'll see some differences, though, and there are several reasons for these differences. One example relates to the letter C. In English spelling, this letter does not have a consistent pronunciation. In call, the letter C says k, while in ceiling, the same letter says s. One principle of phonetic transcription is that we want each symbol we use to have a consistent relationship to a specific speech sound. Because letter C doesn't do this in English, we don't use the phonetic symbol that looks like the letter C to represent the sound in call or the sound in the word ceiling. It turns out that the symbol C is used for phonetic transcription, but not in English. We'll worry about that later. For right now, just know that we'll use this symbol for the sound in the word call and this symbol for the sound in the word ceiling. The principle that we want to adhere to is a strict sound-symbol correspondence. In other words, for each sound, we want to ensure that we have one and only one symbol that we use to represent that sound. A second difference you'll see in phonetic transcription is that the phonetic alphabet uses some specialized symbols to represent sounds that don't have a letter in standard orthography. For example, you'll see that the SH sound, as in shake, which sounds like sh, is transcribed with this symbol. Now you might ask why we have to use a special symbol for this sound when standard orthography does a pretty good job of consistently representing this sound by using two letters, S and H. In fact, SH almost always says sh in English words, so why can't we just leave well enough alone? The answer to this is that the phonetic alphabet also wants us to maintain a strict one-sound, one-symbol relationship. This means that where we have a single sound, we want to represent the fact that it is a single sound unit by using a single symbolic unit to represent that sound. So digraphs like SH are out. Instead, the phonetic alphabet uses other symbols to represent sounds that have often been spelled using digraphs.